Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to take a look at the liquid state, and in particular, the effect it has on vapor pressure. So, we're going to say that vapor pressure is defined as the partial pressure of vapor molecules above the surface of the liquid under the dynamic equilibrium conditions of vaporization and condensation. Now, what does this mean? All this means is that vapor pressure is when the rates of condensation and vaporization are equal to one another. So think about it. In practical terms, let's say you're boiling a pot of water and it has a lid. And I know I'm not a great drawer, but I'm trying here. So in this pot, we have liquid. What do we do to it? We're gonna heat it up. And once we start heating up a pot of water, what's gonna happen? Slowly but surely, the water is gonna start to boil. And once it starts to boil, this liquid is gonna get vaporized into gas. So we're gonna actually have gas molecules exiting the liquid. Now, eventually, those gas molecules will reach to the top of the lid, which is considerably cooler than the actual boiling water. So once these gas molecules touch the lid, what's gonna happen? They're gonna condense back into a liquid. So what's gonna happen now is they're gonna start dripping down back into the boiling water, only to be vaporized once again into gas, go back up, condense again, drop back down, vaporize again, go back up. So this is a continuous process. So we're saying vapor pressure is when the rate of vaporization or evaporation equals the rate of condensation. And remember, vaporization, we're going from liquid to gas, and then condensation, we're going from gas back down to liquid. So vapor pressure is basically when these things are in equilibrium with each other.